Now, one of the really confusing examples is bear paws. If bears have been killed by hunters, they typically remove the coat or the pelt and cut through the distal phalanges to retain the claws with the pelt. The hands and feet of the bear actually have a lot of similarities with humans. And sometimes these are accidentally found by people in the area where the carcass was left. Or those who knew or know of these similarities play jokes on others by leaving the paws to be found by unsuspecting individuals. There are some differences in that bear paws have phalanges with deep V on the proximal end, and the foot of the calcaneus is long and thin on a bear. Let's take a look at some of those. So if you find something like this, the claw is probably going to be your dead giveaway. This is the distal phalanx or distal finger bone on the bear, and you can see that this is fairly distinctive, and that might give you some clues as to what the identification is of these. Certainly if you were comparing those to, say, the human foot here, or the human hand here. But we often don't get this kind of material in this shape with the claws still retaining. If a hunter is finding these, what he's doing very often, or she is doing, is cutting off the pelt and then cutting through the distal phalanx, so this joint here, in order to keep the claws with the pelt itself. And so what we're left with is something that often looks much more like this, maybe with a row of fingers, but not with the distal ends. And this piece of bone looks remarkably a bit more like this kind of bone, especially where this in the same kind of desiccated state. But there are features of this bone that are very different from what you would see on the human. And just looking at that, there's a couple of areas that you would go to. One of those is going to be on the calcaneus. That's this large bone in the heel, which in the human is quite broad because that's where we put our weight as we walk. But in the bear, that is very narrow and thin here. So even though the talus, this bone here, looks very similar, these are differences that you can go to. The other area that you want to look at, and you can see here on the phalanges or finger bones, is that they end in the distal end or the furthest end away from the body in a deep V right in here. Whereas when you look at the human, look at that same bone, these are, this is on the first toe, but this is the second, they have a little depression there, but it's not that deep V shape. And so that is a very huge distinction between these bones. You can also see that when you look at some of the bones on the hand. These are some of the cleaned bones off the hand. And you can see here on the metacarpals, these are the bones which would be on our palm. These ones have a very sharp ridge on the inner surface of the body. And if you look at these in the human, you really don't have that. That's a completely rounded area right in here compared to what you would see on the bear. So those are just some things to look at to give you the difference between those. If you see some of these features, what you then have to do is go and take another look and maybe raise your suspicions that what you're looking at is not human.